In this learning module, we will examine the ways in which you can mark data of interest in Spotfire visualizations. In addition to learning how to interact with data in different visualization types via marking, you should also have some appreciation for the myriad number of reasons why you might want to mark data. Let's get right to a demonstration. Use Open File and navigate to the example with Marking Data in the title. Click Open and agree to the terms and conditions of use. Marking data in a visualization is often as easy as clicking on the item of interest. If you want to mark multiple items, click and drag to form a rectangle. Items contacted by the rectangle will become marked. In most visualization types, marked data will stand out from the faded, unmarked data. Often, the data you wish to mark does not conform to a rectangular shape. In these situations, you can hold the Alt key while clicking and dragging to create a freeform lasso of any shape you choose. Note that as you mark a new group of items, the previously marked data is unmarked. If you wish to add to the existing marked data, you can hold the Control key while performing any of the aforementioned marking operations. Click and drag a rectangle, or while holding both the Control and Alt keys, you can click and drag a lasso shape. In addition to adding to the marked data by holding down the Control key, you can also subtract specific items from the marked data subset. Just hold the Control key and apply any of the marking operations to data which is already marked. If you wish to clear all of the marked data in a visualization, the easiest solution is to click where there's nothing while holding no keys. If you click where there's nothing, nothing will be marked. Because each visualization type is comprised of different items, the way in which you mark data may differ depending upon the type of visualization items with which you are interacting. Scatter plots contain markers, while bar charts contain bars or bar segments, pies contain sectors, heat maps contain cells, and also may contain dendrograms, and line charts contain both lines and markers. Marking in a bar chart highlights the fact that one need only cross a portion of a visualization item in order to mark the data associated with that entire item. This can be particularly useful when you wish to mark the tallest bars in a region of a bar chart. Note that the segments of a bar chart represent individual visualization items which can be marked. Also, note that while marking is shared across visualizations which are configured to use the same marking, it does matter which item in which visualization has been selected by marking. For example, if we click on the blue sector in this pie chart, 277 rows of data are marked. However, if we mark one of the blue segments in this bar chart, a subset of that data is marked because the x-axis variable in the bar chart splits that data differently than do the pie sectors. So we know that the data marked in bar chart B lies solely within this sector of the pie chart. However, it does not represent all of the data in this sector of the pie chart. Because line charts are comprised of both lines and markers, you can mark individual markers by clicking or capturing a group of markers with a rectangle or lasso. If you want to mark an entire line, click on the line between the markers, and of course hold the Control key in order to mark multiple lines in this manner. In a heat map, you can mark cells, or you can mark nodes in the dendrogram. With the heat map, as well as other visualization types, you may find it difficult to find empty space in which to click in order to clear the marked data. If you experience this issue, try using the menu which is presented when you right-click somewhere in the middle of the visualization. The Marked Rows submenu affords you the opportunity to unmark data. If we mark the tallest bars in bar chart A, the same right-click submenu, where we located the unmark option, also gives you the ability to invert marked data. You may find this useful if it is easier to mark the items you do not want than it is to mark the items you do want within a given visualization. Now that you know how to mark data, let's take a moment to consider some of the reasons why you may want to mark data. Often, one marks data in an effort to drill down to get more information about data of interest. Note that the Details on Demand panel shows the raw data from the underlying data table, which supports the marked items. Also note that two details visualizations have been configured on this page. Therefore, it is only the data from these marked rows which is presented in the details visualizations. In fact, marking may also be performed in order to answer the question, how many, as the count of marked rows is available here in the status bar. And of course, the information related in the details on demand, details visualizations, and the status bar will change as different data is marked in the active visualization, or data in the active visualization is unmarked. Data may also be marked in order to identify select rows for follow-up actions. Let's mark a single outlier and use this same right-click submenu we used to unmark data in order to delete the unwanted row of data. When you choose to delete marked data, the rows will be removed from the underlying data table, and you can see that impact on the total number of rows displayed here in the status bar. You can also mark data in order to filter out rows. As the status bar indicates, these rows are not deleted from the underlying data table, but are filtered away from visualizations, at least temporarily. Resetting all filters will return these values to the visualization. You can also filter to a marked subset of data. This is often useful as a method of zooming in to a specific subset of data in a visualization. Again, the Reset All Filters icon will return all data to the visualization. Of course, this is just the tip of the iceberg regarding the reasons you may wish to mark data in Spotfire. You may wish to export the rows of data defined by marking. Tags are attached to marked rows. Lists are created from marked data. Bookmarks can capture the current state of markings. The data provided as input to data functions can be limited to marked rows. Load on-demand data tables can use marked rows to trigger dynamic queries from information links or data connections. And the list goes on and on. Before leaving the topic of marking, you may have noticed that the default settings for most visualizations will identify marked data by fading the unmarked data. However, tables and crosstables will, by default, use a separate color for marked items. You can see how the color of the marked cells in this crosstable have turned green. If we do not wish for the marking color to mask the color gradient which has been applied to this crosstable, we can go to the Properties dialog and to the Appearance section and uncheck this box. Then, close the Properties dialog in order to observe the impact of that change. There may also be occasions where you wish to apply the marking color on a visualization when it was not provided by default. For example, in this scatter plot, we may wish to make the marker stand out with the dark green marking color. We could go to the Properties dialog and to the Appearance section and check this box. Then, close the Properties dialog in order to examine the impact of this change. These changes in appearance of markings are just that, a change in appearance. Changing the setting to use the marking color for marked items has no impact on the behavior of marking relative to the utility of marking data we have discussed in this learning module, other than to point out one of the most obvious reasons why one might mark data, in order to make items stand out from other items visually. Finally, the visualizations on this page, because they share the same marking, cause related items to stand out in both visualizations. However, on the next page, two visualizations have been configured to use different markings. Marking data in this plot turns markers red and defines a subset of values we have labeled marking A, while marking in this plot defines an entirely different subset of data, indicated with blue markers, which we have labeled marking B. In situations where multiple markings have been configured, the details on demand and the status bar reflect the data which is marked in the active visualization. In addition, because there is now more than one subset of data defined by marking, all of the uses for marking which we have discussed can now be served by either of these marked data subsets, including highlighting selected visualization items, drill down, relating items across visualizations, row count, filtering, deleting rows, exporting data, triggering load on-demand data table queries, providing input to data functions, indicating rows to attach to tags, values to assign to lists, and to serve as a visualization aspect which is captured as part of a bookmark state of an analysis.